Minister of Foreign Affairs General J.J. Udon says many Ugandans trapped in Afghanistan are not willing to be evacuated despite the government's efforts to help them flee the extreme Taliban regime. Now, Udon also disclosed to the Parliamentary Committee on Foreign Affairs that the embattled blogger Fred Kajubi, also known as Lumbuye, is still in Turkey as talks on his extradition continue between the government there and the government of Uganda. While appearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Foreign Affairs, Minister of Foreign Affairs General J.J. Udon told MPs that many Ugandans are hesitant to flee Afghanistan despite political unrest that followed the takeover by the Taliban militant government. He noted that they are working with the U.S. to evacuate Ugandans, but many are hesitant to leave.
There are also some Ugandans in Afghanistan who are unwilling to return at this time. They simply say, we are okay, we don't want to leave. So we cannot force them to leave.
The minister revealed that they do not expect any more Afghan evacuees to come to Uganda on top of the 51 who already arrived in the country last week.
The story of these rumors or story that there's another plane load of Afghans coming to Uganda, we have not heard that story. But however, the process of evacuation of Afghanistan is winding down. But that does not prevent Afghans still come to Uganda. The countries which have taken excessive number of Afghanistans and are now finding a challenge in accommodating them.
But committee members expressed fears over the risk associated to hosting Afghans in Uganda, saying they may turn out to be a security threat, which General J.J. Udon dismissed.
These people have been traumatized. They have gone through so much. And we have seen Americans and UK and other countries have tried to help them, but they have been defeated one way or the other. How sure you as a country, as a small country as Uganda, that you are going to help these people? And do you have any measures you are putting in place that these people who are coming, traumatized or not, that they might not go in their kitchen or our kitchens and use homemade bombs and bomb us in this country?
As a ministry and other departments, have we taken into consideration the risk assessment in as far as we are hosting these refugees, the risk assessment to us?
I would like to assure you that you have the benefit of your Minister of Foreign Affairs, who also happens to be a general, who therefore does not take these matters lightly. He takes it considering all of these implications. So the point is, yes, we have carried out, we do carry, we continue to assess and modify our stance in as far as this matter is concerned.
The State Minister for Foreign Affairs, Okello Oryem, told the committee that Afghans are a great deal of foreign exchange to Uganda because hotels accommodating them are reaping big.
If we had brought 2,000 Afghans in this country and they had taken over all these hotels which are empty and we charged them $150 a night and they stayed here for 3 months, 6 months, so what? Dollars will be rolling every day in these hotels which are empty now. Dollars will be rolling, plus, every day. Now we are scaring them off. Ooh, they are terrorists. Oh, there is.
Committee members were also asked at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs for looking on helplessly as Ugandans are being killed in South Sudan. Members of Parliament are concerned that Ugandans are not being treated with dignity in neighboring countries, whereas Ugandans are very hospitable to foreigners.
Our people are really being tortured and killed in these countries, in these two countries. First of all, these are people we take as brothers whenever they come to our country, and they have never got such a mistreatment in our country. And Honorable Okello Oryem has tried to explain something which I didn't pick well, that maybe the measures government is speaking to try to stop this really completely. Because we know that especially Sudan, South Sudan and Congo, their livelihoods depend on Uganda.
Let's talk about regional aspects. The last time I recall, I don't know if South Sudan is is a member of the East African community, but even if not, what is Uganda? What is the recommendation of the ministry to Uganda as a country and to the East African community? Can there be joint efforts, be it security operation, in terms of ensuring safe routes for our nationals?
Sudanese can come here, they are treated in a very diplomatic way. They do all that they wish to do in Uganda, and they go back safely. Why should Ugandans be punished up to this extent? And even to some extent, killing them, an unhandless killing.
It's from this interface that the Minister for Foreign Affairs, JJ Odon, confirmed that the embattled Turkey-based blogger, Fred Kajubi, also known as Lumbuye, is still in Turkey as talks are undergoing between the government of Uganda and Turkey to extradite him.
It is not correct to try to get blood out of a stone. I have stated clearly, last time we met here on the 19th, that Lumbuye is in Turkey. So what else do you want me to say?
The regime's radical critic Lumbuye went missing earlier this month in Turkey, and his fate has remained a subject of speculation. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.